Hello everyone, my name is Maria and in this video I'm going to be discussing how to choose the measures for your improvement project. And measurement for quality improvement is absolutely key. One of the founders of improvement science, the famous Edward Deming, once said, and he's often quoted as, "In God we trust and all others bring data." And you find this in your day-to-day working. You can make a much stronger case for things if you have the data to back up your positions. And this data helps you understand the systems and the processes around you, the systems and the processes within which you work. So measurement and the gathering of this data is a very important part of quality improvement. But you mustn't fall into the measurement trap. Simply measuring a system or a process is not enough to improve it. Einstein famously said that the definition of insanity is doing the same things over and over again, but expecting different results. Improvement requires change. They go hand in hand. To make something better, you need to change something. But not all change results in improvement. And the only way to tell if your changes make a difference is to measure something. But falling into this measurement trap is easier than you might think. We are in the middle of a digital revolution, and the quote you see here is absolutely astonishing. 90% of the world's data has been generated over the last 2 years. This is far more than anyone can ever hope to analyze in their lifetime over multiple lifetimes. More and more data is being collected every day. How do we even begin to ascend this mountain of data to improve patient and perioperative care? Well, it's by keeping it simple. Measurement in the literature is split into measurement for three things: measurement for research, measurement for judgment, and measurement for improvement. So let's look at each of these in turn. Now here you see a statue of research holding the torch of knowledge. Most of us are familiar with measurement for research, where most commonly two or more treatments are compared with one another. And we are familiar with the words that we use here. We have heard about randomized controlled trials, before and after treatments, power calculations, statistics, so on and so forth. This is the way this kind of measurement leads to evidence-based knowledge, and it furthers the fields of science. But this isn't the way to improve. A child doesn't learn how to ride a bike by performing a randomized controlled trial. In the real messy world within which we live, we learn over time, we learn step by step, we learn by making mistakes and getting up and trying again and getting slowly and steadily better. Here we see Lady Justice. And measurement for judgment or accountability is when we use the data to assess performance against a set standard or targets. And this kind of data is useful, for example, to benchmark your own performance against others and maybe tell you that you need to improve in some areas. But it doesn't help you to improve. So this is what we're talking about today: measurement for improvement. And here we see Florence Nightingale, who improved the healthcare for the wounded on the front lines. She used graphical representations of data to improve levels of sanitation and ultimately outcomes for her patients. So measurement for improvement is used to demonstrate that any changes you make result in an improvement. It's a dynamic approach to measurement. You measure your outcomes and processes within your system over time, and you're continually learning. Making changes, you're learning from them. If the changes work, that's great. You keep them and you learn from them and you build on them. If the changes don't work, you learn from them and you stop doing whatever that was and you move on to something else. It's a continual dynamic process and it's all about learning. And all you need to do to achieve this is just to find a few simple key measures that are relevant to you and your improvement project. You don't need large, extensive data sets. Just a few key measures, that's all you and your team need to see how you're progressing towards your improvement goals. And to choose those vital few measures, you gather your team together and discuss what measures are relevant to you and your improvement aims, and always bearing in mind who will be collecting this data and how often. It has to be a simple and easy process, otherwise it just won't happen. And for the PQIP project, we have ensured that the measures we have chosen are important measures for the quality of perioperative care. For example, the proportion of patients on an enhanced recovery pathway, or patient satisfaction on day one after surgery, or post-operative length of stay, amongst many others. And with our online data collection tool, we have made the entry of this data and the feedback of data back to you very, very easy and straightforward. How do we know how many measures are enough? The very simple answer is you need to measure enough to learn. Too little measurement and you're at risk of not really understanding the systems and processes around you. Too much measurement and you risk overwhelming the team and creating so much work you just can't get the measurements done. Just the right amount is what you need, and that is the real heart of quality improvement. It's about continual learning. Now, I hope you enjoyed this talk. Please watch our other tutorials on the PQIP channel, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.